So, should you trust scientists? This may be a question that has entered your mind because of the current political situation we are in. There is a lot of politicization of science. Politicians using science as a chess piece. I think this is incredibly wrong for any politician, regardless of what party affiliation they might have, to do, because science is meant to serve everybody. Should you trust scientists, the expert practitioners of science? Well, full disclosure, I'm a scientist. Of course, I have a bias. I think you should trust scientists, but let me explain why I think that is. And to do that, I want to explain to you what it takes to be a professional scientist, what it takes to be an expert in a specific scientific discipline. So, as a young scientist, you start out reading intensively about all of the previous research that had come before you. You're standing on the shoulders of giants, and you're trying to identify, this is very challenging, especially early on, what gaps in knowledge exist, and even more challenging, how do we fill those? People haven't been able to do that yet. So you've got to get good at that. You've got to get good at identifying gaps in knowledge, that which means you need to really know all of the current knowledge about the specific kinds of questions you're asking. And then you have to get really, really good, the best in the world in many cases, at figuring out how to fill those gaps, using different kinds of studies, different kinds of scientific approaches to, as objectively as you possibly can, fill those gaps. And there's a lot of checks and balances in place to make sure that you are doing your best to be objective. First, to get science funded, you have to convince usually other scientists, but certainly boards of individuals evaluating the quality of proposed research before you can get grant money to do your research. So in many cases, it's leaders in your discipline that are first evaluating whether your research is even worth being done. Once you get that, you get the grant money, check, okay, great, now it's time to do the research. You do the research. Once you're done with that work, you write it up, you publish it in a scientific journal. But before it actually gets published, it goes through another round of intense assessment. And this is always done by peers in your field. And they are trying their hardest to identify inadequacies and errors and anything that makes your science unsound. And that is an understood job and role that we all play as scientists. We want to make sure that the science that gets published is legitimate. And so when a scientist is able to successfully do what I just described iteratively, meaning they're frequently getting grants, they're frequently convincing grant committees that their research is legit, they're frequently publishing scientific papers in leading journals. If they can do all of those things, then they can be deemed an expert in a certain area of research. And that is when you might hear the findings of this individual and maybe the opinions of this individual in mainstream media. To get to that point where you're hearing what this scientist has to say, you're hearing his or her conclusions about a study, they had to do a lot in almost all cases. And of course, it's going to depend on which media you're consuming. But for legitimate media, to get to that point, that scientist had to go through a ton of assessments, and they essentially had to become one of the best. Science, like many disciplines, is incredibly competitive. So to get to that point where you're hearing what they have to say, this scientist has proven themselves to their peers, and the whole point of that proving is to show that they are legit. They're trying to find objective answers. They're not trying to make up data. They're not trying to pull out false conclusions. They're not trying to do things to be famous, to push some kind of agenda, to get kickbacks from some industry. No, those things, I think in most cases, will get sussed out way earlier. And that kind of career will plummet, because if you get a bad reputation and you get a reputation for being not legit, you simply will not be employed in the scientific discipline. Of course, there are scientists that work for corporate entities and actually work for lobbying groups and things like this, but that's an entirely separate thing. I wouldn't even call those people scientists. I'm talking about legitimate scientists that work for research institutions, like academic institutions, research labs, government labs, things like that. So should you listen? I would argue yes, and I would argue that they have earned your attention by how much they've gone through to get to the point where they're able to share their findings with you, which again, those findings come from from a long history of intense assessment and incredible dedication. So there you have it. Thank you for watching. As usual, subscribe, like, share. Also, leave comments for me on video topics that you'd like me to do in the future. Generally, I want to share the secret, unfortunately secret, world of science with the public because science is meant to serve the public. Any ideas you might have about cool ways that I can sort of bridge the gap between the public and science, I'd love to hear it. Leave it in the comment section, and I will do my best to make future videos that directly address questions and comments from you guys. Thank you so much.